children, here we are going to have a class in botany, chapter 1, asexual and sexual reproduction in plants. And in that topic, we are going to deal about female reproductive part of the flower. In that we can call it as what? Gynoecium. The gynoecium is a female reproductive part of the flower in mostly angiosperms. And the gynoecium is comprised of one or more pistils. Each pistil has three important parts: the ovary, the style, and stigma. And this, I've shown the diagram here, you just listen. This is the ovary, and every flower has the female reproductive part, that the gynoecium has the three parts. You know, when you cut this ovary, only you can find ovule. Our real topic is about the structure of ovule. Okay, so where is it present? When you cut the seed, ovary, seeds of ovary can have what? Ovules inside. Here we can see the ovule structure. It's also called as megasporangium. Megasporangium, okay? The megaspore would be present inside, which we can call it as ovule. The ovule is a part where after the fertilization, it will become seed. The ovule, you know, it's present inside the ovary. The ovule comprises of two important parts, the stalk and the body. The ovule stalk is also called as funicle or funiculus. The body of the ovule is attached with the help of the funicle to the placenta of the flower. And here, the funicle and the body of the ovule have a junction in between, which we can call it as hilum. And the center part of the ovule, that the body of the ovule is comprised of large amount of reserved food material, which we can call it as a nucellus. It is not nucleus, it is nucellus. Then apart from there, you know, the micropyle. This is an anatropous ovule, where we can see the micropyle. There is a small opening which is present in between the integument. The integuments are the outer covering, which are two in number. If one integument is present, the ovule is called as unitegmic. If two integuments is present, we can call this ovule as bitegmic. The micropyle is a very minute opening where we can have the minute opening through which the fertilization came to occur. And opposite to the micropyle, there is an end called chalazal end, chalaza. See, opposite to the micropyle. In the ovule, we are looking in the book, we are having anatropous ovule, where the explanation is given for the orthotropous ovule. And in the chalazal end, many of the angiosperm have the fertilization function through porogamy. And here, the embryo sac is present in the center of the body of the ovule, and where the egg nucleus is present. It is a 7-celled egg nucleated embryo sac. Here, three parts we are seeing is the polar nuclei, where the three are above the antipodal cell. The central cell is called the egg apparatus, and this is about the ovule of the angiosperm. Orthotropous, anatropous, hemianotropous, caphyotropous, amphitropous, and sarsinotropous. Orthotropous, we can have the funicle, the micropyle, and the chalaza all in a straight line. It is very common in all the angiosperms. Second one, anatropous, 80% of the angiosperm possess this anatropous ovule, where we can have an inverted ovule, and here the micropyle and funicle like right angles to each other. And any anatropous is straight, it is a vertical straight line. We can have the micropyle, chalaza in a vertical line, we can have. And the caphyotropous is also called as a V-shaped ovule, whereas the amphitropous, which we know, it is a horseshoe shaped ovule, and it's present in prumulaceae, whereas the sarsinotropous, it is present in the cacti seed, and the funicle coils freely in the atmos the it has a coil position of the globule, and this will be common in the if we are cactus. Then we'll see the development of the ovule or the embryosac. Children, here in the ovule, the development is quite crucial, and it follows the formation of some cell. In the center, it has some cell which are actively nutritive, and they are giving the nourishment to the growing cell. One of the cell in the epidermis acts as a episporial cell. You know, below the epidermis. Hypodermal cell, one of the cell act as episporial initial, and they going divide mitotically and give rise to megaspore mother cell. Megaspore mother cell and give rise to megaspore, which is also called as megasporogenesis. Megasporogenesis means the formation of the megaspore from the megaspore mother cell. Normally, 4 megaspore will be formed, and apart from that, only one will be functional. If one will be functional, then we can call it as a monosporic development of ovule. Monosporic development of ovule. If 2 megaspore will function as a embryo, and we can call it as a bisporic development. And if 4 megaspore cell are involved in the development of the embryo, we can call it as for tetraspore. And here, in the case of polygonum, only one megaspore is functional, and it undergoes mitotic division and form 2 cell stage. After that, the 2 cell will go like each other oppositely, and they undergo another mitotic division to form 4 nucleated state. And here, the 4 nuclei, no cellular wall formation would be occur, only in the nucleus divide, and they give rise to 4 nucleus, and upon division, again they undergo mitotic division to form 8 nucleated state, that is a 8 nucleated embryo sac, monosporic embryo sac would be formed. This is very common in the case of polygonum. The polygonaceae or the most examplized angiosperm present. Thank you.